Once again, it's Coins Euro Trip.
This is Coins Euro Trip. You're watching Normandy D-Day.
Here is France. And up on the northwest side is a region called Normandy. I stayed in this little town called Bayeux. This is a perfectly preserved medieval village with a population of about 15,000 people. This town is filled with stone mansions, cobblestone streets, and timbered houses. Bayeux was the first town liberated after the D-Day landings. A river flows through Bayeux. Oh, the scenic views, the birdies. This town miraculously escaped much of the bombings of World War II, which is the reason why it's such an attractive town today. Little cafes, shops, good food, nice wine. You may want to reserve ahead one of the tours if you're going during the tourist season. I just showed up in my lofted room hotel, grabbed one of the brochures, and called them from the front desk.
So needless to say, you can take half-day tours here in the Normandy region. However, I'm a nut about World War II history, and I think it's more advisable. I was going to rent a car, but a lot of the tours actually includes the museums that I'm going to right now. So take a tour, 75 euros, around 100 and some what odd dollars, depending on what day the American whatever currency decides to take a nosedive, or wherever you're from. 75 euros is about the average price, half a day. Or take a half day, just take a day.
If we overshoot, we come down like clay pigeons smack dab in the center of San Miraglis.
The first stop in this tour van was at San Miraglis. Look, there is a paratrooper hanging from a parachute that is stuck on the church steeple. Private John M. Steele was an American paratrooper from the 82nd Airborne that was dropped with his comrades right over this Nazi-occupied town. German soldiers and villagers were in the town square putting out a fire from a bomb that was dropped earlier. The paratroopers were easy targets, and Steele was one of the few non-casualties. His predicament and position did not go unnoticed by the Nazis. The wounded paratrooper dangled for 2 hours pretending to be dead before the Germans took him prisoner.
The Nazis would take the sniper tower right where Mr. Steele had his parachute stuck. They'd be shooting at the oncoming parachuters.
His parachute slowly began slipping. He thought it was the weight of all of his gear, but actually it was German snipers in this tower that were cutting his cords with their knives. John Steele survived the war, and later he became an honorary citizen of San Miraglis. He's still hanging out.
Here I am in the square of San Miraglis Church. A lot of things happened here, a lot of battles. The 82nd Airborne came and fell into this ground under Nazi occupation. What's interesting about this place is pretty much well preserved. Right behind me there, I was informed this is actually a Roman placement saying, hey, this is Rome.
Drow!
And of course, it's been Christianized since then.
Just right across the way from John Steele and this historic plaza is the museum that is included in the tour.
The Screaming Eagles. Going into a museum now. We have a Sherman tank, looks like right here.
They call this automobile a half truck. Now to me, it looks like a half truck and a half tank, so trank? Inside this cool museum, they have everything from helmets, dog tags, uniforms, guns, weapons of all kind. Friend or foe? Friend.
The museums are great here. They have actual live mannequins here. But they're not saying anything to me. I think they're still shocked from the shells. Kurahi. It's not vaudeville, folks.
This was a code phrase on radio that let the French underground know D-Day was about to begin.
Blesse mon cœur d'une langueur monotone.
Love that. That's what I'd like to have. Right there. The mini tank motorcycle. And obviously propellers from a bad landing. Well, maybe hopefully it's a good landing. If you come on in, we're going to look at the inside of a C-47.
The Argonia was the first of the flying farmers that was organized in Argonia, Kansas.
Buy, 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 buy a bond. And by, the bonds you buy will bring you victory.
It ain't no whale tale.
Buy, 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 buy a bond. And you'll be standing by the victory arch when Johnny comes marching home again. Oh, you.
I believe it was made of canvas and wood hang gliders that was pulled from the airplanes.
This glider had no engine. It had to be pulled by the C-47 into the air and then released.
Clear for landing. Cut loose now. And out.
It was built by the Ford Motor Company and designed to carry 15 soldiers. It could then fly silently over occupied air.
I think fascinating about this large plane. If you go up to the thing here. This particular glider flew in here on the 6th, 7th, or 8th of the invasion. Come on, let's go inside. Into this.
They were mostly used to carry personnel and supplies, but were capable of carrying a jeep.
We shall send you, in ever-increasing numbers, ships, planes, tanks, guns. That is our purpose and our pledge.
Nice.
Assembled Congress, here's the President and his promise to all people fighting aggression.
Supplies from the United States pouring into Britain
to help crush the madman of Europe. We're in the war now.
Ooh. Warm and sound, smells like camping from the 70s.
Be sure to watch Normandy D-Day Part 2. Coin will take you to Utah Beach, Omaha Beach, and the cliffs of Pont du Hoc.